Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. For the standard SpaceX updates, we have almost nothing except a delay to the SXM7 launch. In Boca Chica, however, we have a whole bunch of updates including the SN8 remains and SN9 problems. Let's head straight in and get up to date. SpaceX were expected to launch the SXM7 satellite on Friday but scrubbed the launch just before liftoff. They tweeted, "Standing down from today's launch attempt to perform additional ground system checkouts, teams are working toward no earlier than Sunday, December 13th for next launch attempt." So, as you can see on the SpaceXFans website, we can expect it to lift off today at 4:22pm UTC or 11:22am EDT. An interesting article has been posted where apparently Indonesia has invited SpaceX to assess the possibility of setting up a launch site there. As I said, we have very few standard updates, so in Boca Chica we can see engineers have been working on the suborbital mount at Pad B. This was possibly in preparation for SN9's arrival, which has now been delayed. Also possibly in relation to SN9, we have SpaceX's giant rented crane known as Tankzilla seen on the move. Forklifts were seen assisting Tankzilla by grabbing beams of wood from the rear to continue the path forward. Outside in the construction yard, we have a great shot of the collection of super heavy ring stacks as well as the Starship nose cone and other pieces. Starship Mark 1 was SpaceX's very first full-size Starship and the nose has been disassembled further as you can see. The windbreaker building, which SpaceX now uses for stacking Starship nose cones to barrel sections, has a ring stack sitting inside. Also, in terms of noses, inside the nose cone fabrication tent we have some under construction. This nose in front is possibly for SN10 and already has aerosurface covers for the canards. A new ring stack was seen moved outside and this is the section to be sleeved with an upper bulkhead for the forward stack of a new Starship. There was a liquid oxygen downcomer seen being moved around. This feeds propellant from the nose cone header tank down to the engines. For those who may have missed it, SpaceX launched SN8 on Wednesday, not long after my updates video. Here's some great tracking footage from Mary's view. She was out there for many hours to film this. Also, NASA spaceflight member Jack Beyer, who usually edits the NSF videos, was out there for many hours capturing more awesome footage. I want to share an epic shot of the SN8 launch which SpaceX posted on Twitter, just spectacular. SpaceX also posted this phenomenal footage from below of the SN8 landing flip maneuver. For those who didn't watch my video on Thursday, here is a tweet from Elon Musk explaining why the prototype didn't stick the landing. He said, "Fuel header tank pressure was low during landing burn, causing touchdown velocity to be high and rudd, but we got all the data that we needed." He also tweeted, "After the test flight, SN8 did great, even reaching apogee would have been great, so controlling all the way to putting the crater in the right spot was epic." Looking at the remnants of SN8, Steve Javertson, who is a SpaceX board member, responded to a tweet from S. Padre. He added some close-up shots of the SN8 wreckage. Looking at the remains some more, Elon and his dog, called Marvin the Martian, were spotted walking around and inspecting the prototype pieces. A whole bunch of other people were seen heading onto the landing pad at some point to take a look. Here's another great view where you can see some damage caused to the tent at the orbital launch pad area. The lesson they will probably learn is don't put a tent next to a landing pad for a test vehicle. There was a tweet from S. Padre with a picture of the SN9 nose cone tip which survived in somewhat good condition considering the explosion. Elon Musk was asked if SpaceX could save the nose cone to be kept as a monument to remember. He said, "Agreed, should be preserved in memory of SN8. With SN8 now gone, it was looking good for SN9 which was ready and hanging out in the high bay. Then, in order to hopefully begin the testing campaign for SN9, SpaceX had a road closure on Monday for the SN9 rollout as you can see on the Cameron County website. Unfortunately though, this prototype has had an incident where it's now fallen and is resting on the high bay wall. It's believed that the stand it was sitting on collapsed. Here you can see some of the damage caused, and this will definitely have an impact on the development and testing schedule. Here's another view where you can see one of the body flaps and it's looking like it's got a bit of damage. There's also a view of the nose cone which is now leaning on the high bay wall. It's ironic that SN8 got damaged after achieving so much, and SN9 didn't even leave the production area before sustaining damage. Tankzilla, which we saw on the move earlier, was indeed moved over to the high bay to assist SN9 to place it back upright. Also seen being moved is a new transport stand for SN9 to sit on. We will have to see what happens with SN9, but it's definitely not going anywhere at the moment. So with that unfortunate news, it's not all doom and gloom, as the SN10 tank in the mid bay is probably now waiting for its body flaps, then a nose cone. Alongside it in the mid bay structure is the Starship serial number 11 prototype tank, which is continuing to be worked on. To finish up the video, I'll also share the updated diagram thanks to Brendan Lewis. We now have SN8 gun, but she left a great mark on the Starship program. As I always do, I'd like to say thank you to Mary, known more commonly as Boca Chica Gal, who goes out literally all day every day to film this amazing footage. Also, behind the scenes is the NASA spaceflight team, working super hard with live streams and other amazing space coverage, so thank you to them as well. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.